30. Take this wrap off. Still frozen. Too good. I think it'll help it thaw faster too, as well, so. There we go. So we got 5 patties. Also make these potatoes. We're going to do those in the oven with some peppers and onions. Preheat the oven to 425. over here. So it's not too warm. So as not to get too warm. All right. Let's see. We are going to use, let's see, I'm making ground bigs. Sausage. Roasted potatoes. So this one will go here. This with this here. And I need something like this to hold the weight up. I don't like that. It's still not tall enough. Oops. Let me check out. We got it handled. Now I can use this. Get this one out. See if this will fit in there. Oh, no. It's not small enough. The bottles. Darn it. Sucks so darn. Well, I can't use it with that bottle. I'm gonna have to find a bottle I can use it with and put my oil in that bottle. Where's the piece? There it is. I didn't know, but now I do. So I'm gonna see if it fits in one other bottle, and if it does, when that bottle gets empty, I can use it. Excused. That didn't work either. Because it leaked.
I don't know what to do. Let me see. I suppose I could sell them on eBay or something. Send them back. Return them. For the $1.68 I paid for them. Yeah, I probably won't ever buy anything from that site again. So, those won't work. They do not work. Takes care of that issue. They will not work. All right, well, I'm going to start with a little bit of olive oil there in that pan. Go ahead and put some in that pan. This pan and that pan. You can't even see what pans I'm talking about. This pan and this pan. I know it's not working very well. But I don't know what else to do, I guess. Why did I move you over here? Oh, because I turned the oven on. Yep, turn the oven on. I did. Bit of butter going on here. Butter. I think I'm going to go ahead and there we go. Alright. I am going to go ahead and bring the legs out. Alright. There we go. That's pretty good. So I'm just making breakfast. And we're going to have some sausage, potatoes, and eggs. So these are going to go onto a folding plate. Get this board washed, and we're gonna do the potatoes. Those need to be done first. So we're going to roast these potatoes. So I got the oven preheating to 425. And I'll make the mashed potatoes.
The oven is preheated already? It's crazy fast.
We're gonna roast these with some onions and some peppers. This onion is okay still. I mean for roasting. In the pool, first off. And we might even cut some more. This doesn't seem like it. Okay, so we are going to cut some of the new onion as well. I have tuna onions still. I'm gonna do some garlic. Thank you.
great to me. I'll just keep putting them in until I'm like, okay, that's enough. Right? Aside. Rough chop. We're just doing a real rough chop on the edge. We don't want them at least that big. That's roasting them. Bit of a green one here. Another green one in the refrigerator. But I think just this one will be good. Oh, they put it over. Maybe that was my fingernail. I don't know. I did that. Maybe. I don't know. This is the oven. The potatoes. And I think they'll be fine. I'm going to definitely put one of those seeds in there. Yeah, I probably should get that other one. I think these are about as old as they're willing to get. And then it'll be done. What you doing, Ben?
Huh?
What you doing?
Getting some cheese.
Getting some cheese.
What are you doing?
Cooking.
Okay.
what the other one misses enough, for sure. All right, so we got onions, green peppers, red peppers. Now the potatoes are going in. Rinse, cold water rinse. Cold water coming out here. These are potatoes are kind of on their last. Don't order themselves. So we got some definite eyes coming up off there. And take those out. And then we're just gonna quarter them like that. Plop them in the bowl. Or we might just have some of them will be so small, right? I'm just taking off the little eyelets. So I'll just do that one in half. Most of these will just be in here because they're so small. tossing them all over. Careful.
Thank you.
We're going to put some extra virgin olive oil in there. Quite a bit, actually. I'm going to put a few dabs of butter in there. Just here and there. That's seed right there. Is that good enough butter? Alright, so we are done with the onion and the pepper. So, I'll put the pepper face down. If I don't use this in the next 2 or 3 days, it will go in the garbage. So, I really want to use it before it goes bad. So, I got 2 or 3 days left on this one. I don't want to send it on anything wet there. And then the onions, I will come back to later, pray later today, and get them all cut up for the jar for the week. So this will be my onion for the week. I have one more, so if I use it all, it will be fine, even if I use all this, because I have one more. I'm just going to set that stuff there. There's our, what we got left with that onion. There we go. And these are green onions for the top, for topping the everything. Okay, so we're gonna go in with some, first we're gonna go salt. That's plenty. Put some pepper in there. Put some pepper in there. There we are. And we're gonna do some garlic salt. There we are. We are also going to chop up some. Ooh, I'm gonna try my new garlic thing. That's right. I just got it. Hang on. I moved you a little closer. So hopefully that will be good. I'm going to try my garlic press. I'm going to press my luck with my garlic press. I think you still have to like take the skin off, right? Do you take the skin off? I think so. I mean, what would take the skin off, right? If I didn't. Small, except for that one. Ah, I didn't want to do that. That's what I didn't want to do. Okay, we're going to put some garlic in here and see how we fare. Oh boy. Oh, we got some garlic in there. Some garlic in you. We are going to set that piece aside. Yeah.
Okay.
And rinse this out and try again, because there was paper in there. We got some paper off on that, and it seems to, I don't know what to do at this point, but anyway, it is, that was the first time putting garlic through there, and apparently it had some metal pieces to attend to. Here is the little hole punches that are not all cleared out with that metal, but I think we are good now. So, got everything rinsed off again, and clean up our space here real quick. So there's metal shavings in the garlic right there, so we're gonna throw that away. That's why I just wanted to put a little bit amount in there. I think we got all that taken care of now though. Okay. There we go. Hey babe.
Yeah?
Can you grab me a roll of paper towels, please?
What's that?
Can you grab me a new roll of paper towels?
Yeah.
Thank you, dear. Okay, so I'm just going to put one whole clove in there and see how it comes out. It doesn't want to push all the way through, that's for sure. I really got to force it. I guess that's just how it works, though. You got to force it. I want to make sure, but I don't see any pieces in there. I think we're good. Yep. Looks like we're good. A little bit of paper there. We're going to put a couple more clothes in there, though. Because.
They're on the table, baby.
Thanks, babe. Do with the stuff to get out of there, because it just seems so papery. I guess I don't know how else to explain it. If I were to chop it, that would go in the food. I don't know. Okay. I do like it though. I like being able to just squish it and move on. This is kind of dark. Spot in there. What? What the heck? What the heck is going on? I just cut off all the bunch of tips. Oh well, that's alright. It's gonna dry out though now. After I'm gonna make that garlic this afternoon. So I will definitely use this roll to do so, or this head of garlic to do so. Three nice size garlic cloves in there. This will be number two going in. And now that we have that machine working right, we're not pushing out fibers, metal flakes. I think they would, you know, take care of that before they put it out on the shelf. Because you can't trust people to be smart about these things. Most of the time, they not. Okay, so number two. I'm going to do it over this, I guess. It'll be fine now. It's like I'm ricing the garlic, which I won't do when I process some for the infused oil on cheap garlic. I want to use that too, you know. There's number two, and we're kind of left with a thin layer of dried up, I don't know what. Dried up, I don't know what going on there. I guess that's okay, huh? We're going to need another clove, nice size clove here. Yeah, that's a good one. Okay. Get this one in there. This is the bad piece right here in the whole clove. That's not good at all. All right, well, let me get another one. Another nice size one. It'll be good to be in here. Hopefully when I break this one open, it won't. I saw the dark spot on that one, so I kind of figured it was. I didn't realize that it was going to be so big. There, finally got it off. One more piece. Here we go. Last clove going. I don't know if it's more of a hassle or not. Well, it was mostly peeling the garlic, not. Okay, I saw a little flake here. Got it. Now it makes me want to check the rest of it. Is that just going to keep happening? I think we're okay. I don't know, I don't think I want to put that in my food. I mean, had I cut it, it would have gone in my food, but not that texture, I guess. I like that. Okay, so we're done with that. We got three cloves of garlic in there. Minced. There's a little bit of garlic left in there. And this whole board can be thrown away. What we would do. And we're going to do some paprika. And some minced onion. This gives a nice coating. Helps the garlic or the oil infuse. Let's see, I'll smell these first. I'm going to say no on that. Thyme. Onion powder. And we're going to go with some garlic powder, even though we did garlic salt as well. And we are going to go with the parsley. Uh-oh, it might be too full. Might be too full. Nope. Alright. I'm going to take it up here. There we go. There, that should do it. I'll just keep doing this until it will come out. We're going to take it. Salt. Where's my garlic powder? There it is. On the other side. Onions, two garlics. Alright. Now we're just going to stir this up. Get all these ingredients. All over all the peppers and the potatoes. It's that. Get all the garlic all in there, the butter, the olive oil, everything coated nicely. All right, that looks good. We're just going to pour it right into the pan. As I can spread out on this small pan. My other pan's in the freezer, and I still have truffles to make. My pan's still in the freezer, but I'm sure it'll be fine. I gotta be something towards, I gotta sit down every so often. I think the truffles are like that. Right, so this is going to go in the oven, probably set it, it's $4.25, so I'll probably set it for about 20 minutes, and then we will check it at 20. There we go. So we're going to check it at 20 minutes, and I'll be back and let you know.